I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander far from me, I wanna feel you in my arms again. And you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love, and then softly leave. Show how deep is your love? Is your love how deep is your love? I really need to learn, 'cause we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down. They should all just let us be. We belong to you. Care for you, well, you know down inside that I really do. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love? Is your love? How deep is your love? I really need to learn. 'Cause we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down. They should all just on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love, and then softly leave. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love? Is your love? How deep is your love? I really need to learn. 'Cause we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down. They should your love, how deep is your love? How deep is your love? How deep is your love?
Hi, ladies. Okay. So excited to be here with you. I'm just checking. I think I'm like in action. Okay. Always good to know. Oh my gosh. I feel so excited about this. A little bit of butterflies as I was preparing. But I just, first of all, wanted to thank you all for joining me in this special transmission around graciousness and the lost art of feminine graciousness. And I will say, oh my goodness, graciousness, like I have taught graciousness many times, and it's almost like the more airtime I give graciousness in terms of contemplation and like investigation and also witnessing, like beholding women in the world and the harmonics that live inside of them and the effects of those harmonics onto other women, men, our families, and the world, the more that I really have come to believe that graciousness is like a mystical technology in the same way that art is like evolves, as consciousness evolves, it is the same with graciousness. And so the way we're going to do today and architect today's transmission, and for those of you in my more intimate private teaching spaces, you know how we do this. So we're going to start at the most elemental or terrestrial or gross. There's a word that I'm looking for to describe what I mean by it. Basic. That's the word that I'm there's a word that normal people use to describe this. So we're going to start at the most basic and kind of mortal. And then we're going to move up and into the more mystical dimensions of this mystical, feminine, life-affirming, highly misunderstood, beautiful, potent, creational frequency of graciousness. So some of this, I want to begin by talking about my group, the group that I'm inside of right now, our group together. And so, the reason why that's important is because in our field together, in this group, I have literally one and only rule. I don't even like that word already, request and requirement. And that is your supreme graciousness. So I want to talk about that almost just pre-roll for a second, because fields and spaces are very powerful kind of organisms. So fields in particular, and by field, I mean a shared collective space, which is what we all reside in together when we're in this group together. They're morphic. And what I mean by that is that they have a precise structure and energetic frequency. And morphic fields are very important and very powerful. And I share this almost quasi a sidebar, because this is so important for women, particularly highly coded feminine women, to understand. It is necessary that you bring so much discernment to the fields that you play in, the fields that you share in. And this is because through your participation, you are co-signing and you are kind of organically giving your consent to the codes that architect or kind of that the group gestalt is sourced in. This is so important. And so what you need to know about this group is that this group is sourced in graciousness. And that's what I intentionally code this field with, is the intention and the requirement that we show up in a way that lets us, as highly coded feminine beings, be practitioners of a very high heart frequency called graciousness. And I'm going to keep climbing into this, both with more lived experiences from the group itself, and then more almost a cosmic reckoning with the potency and the lost art of graciousness. So, and this is where this gets so interesting. So in my field, I say there's one requirement and only one, and that is your supreme graciousness. I also say, and this is where things get a bit dynamic, that this is not a safe field. This is not a safe space. I mean that When I say that, I mean that kind of psycho-emotionally. Like, there's no part of me that can guarantee, nor has the desire to, that your feelings are not going to get hurt. That you're not going to experience things that are like, ooh, that does not feel good to me. That is part of this experience. And that creational tension between your graciousness being the fundamental quintessence of requirement to play in this space, and the fact that, like, the very first thing when you agree to be in this group is, this is not a safe space. And your graciousness is required. This is, it wasn't, like, I didn't exactly set that up that way, but I'm like, ooh, that is like such a hot yoking energetically and vibrationally, because this energetic tension requires something of you. And we're going to talk about that in greater detail as we continue to climb into today's transmission. But I will say, at the highest, kind of most meta level, it requires profound responsibility, profound self-responsibility and self-possession, that you can be in a group where you are consenting, ooh, this is not a safe space. I might get a little bit whacked in this field energetically. And here's what you don't get to do. You don't get to come into this group and spill your pain body, or like smear your pain in this group. So I'm going to talk about this almost through a lens. Like I said, we're starting at the most dense and the most basic, and then we're going to continue. And I think you're probably already feeling it to swing out into the higher dimensional implications and opportunities that exist inside of graciousness. And then I'm going to bring it all the way back down to like etiquette. So, okay, this is like, we're in a digital space here together. We are in a virtual field of a free, dicey business, having a free Facebook group. Let me say that, of a free group on Facebook. Oh my goodness. Okay, so, and there's like 1500, I think, something of us in here. We are very blessed, because while this is a very rarefied field and frequency that is like what is encoded into this space, it is still, you answer three little questions and a hop, skip, and a jump, this space is available to you. So if you were, let's say, in a real, physical space, if you were in like a room, and there was many, many people in the room, like 1500 of them, who just so happened to be like highly coded and fellow travelers at the level of soul essence. Would you just strut right up to the stage and grab the mic and be like, here's my thing. Here's where I need help. Here's my pain. Here's what hurts me. Here's where my pain body is inflamed and activated, but not even with that much consciousness. Would you just spill your pain into that field without even greeting the field? No, you wouldn't, I presume. So you don't get to do that here either, because that behavior is an unconscious reflex in response to your pain. That is the antithesis, like graciousness cannot occupy the same psychic space as pain body, as unconsciousness. Graciousness, by definition, requires a conscious relationship to our embodiment. It is a cultivation. It's like ballet rather than being in like some kind of gnarly mosh pit. Is that what they're called? I don't know. Or like, yeah, some sort of like where you get to go and like get it all out. This is not the right space for that. And having said that, okay, I should probably just say, teachings of the feminine, or teaching the feminine, or being a teacher of feminine principles, feminine awakening, at its essence has two very complex aspects or features. One is layers and levels. Oh my goodness, we move up and down layers and levels inside of the same subject matter all day long. And then to add even a little extra kicker to that, inside the levels and layers is untold paradox. And this is because the feminine in her quintessence is highly, highly paradoxical. That is one of the natures of, or qualities of, mystery itself, is profound paradox. So I'm going to say one thing, and then I'm going to say something where you're like, might be like, ooh, that feels almost opposite too. And it's not that it's opposite. It's that it's highly, highly, like energy. It's encoded with tension. It's like tension exists between two poles or two qualities that are connected along a spectrum. So there is a sameness and a simultaneity, and yet they have the capacity to be stretched very far away from one another while still existing in a frequency of union or sameness. So while I just said, ooh, you do not get to come to this field and spill your pain body and to like just smear your pain and your hurt all over this field, you do get to come to this field, and we see it every day, multiple times a day, seeking counsel, seeking reflection, and by the grace, secret hint in that word, of God, we are blessed with so much profound feminine wisdom and gnosis in this group. So that is a very deep blessing that I, not for a hot second, do I take that for granted. And neither should any of you, because you are the ones that are creating that for one another and receiving the fruits of what it is that you're creating. So, and this, I'm going to say, I have to make a like correction, or I have to refine some of my languaging when you come into this field, because one of the things that I do want to emphasize is that when you come into this field, your graciousness is required. This is not a safe space. And number three, which I have not really like lifted fully into articulated consciousness yet, is that you are agreeing to receive my adjustments. You are agreeing to receive my energetic correction. Because when I talked about fields a little bit ago and how fields are encoded at the level of the morphic field with frequency, this field, and I don't, this is value neutral. There's no like ego in this when I say this. This field is encoded in my emanation. So let's talk about that word emanation, because this is a big part of graciousness too. Emanation is like something that bloop, 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 like it It's centrifugal. So it has a single source point. And then from that, it's like vibrational strands or like spokes of a wheel or like puffs of a tone or a frequency. They emanate from that singular source point. And so in this Facebook group, because I started it and because it's encoded in my body of work, this is encoded in my emanation. I carry and embody high levels, highly saturated with codes of graciousness. Please stand by. Highly imperfectly. And it's true for me at the level of soul essence. It's true for me at the level of what I call the gold print. So because that's true for me at the level of emanation, it means that this field is an expression of that core frequency that is encoded in the gold print that dwells within me, given kind of a gift of God, a gift, again, value neutral. And so I feel it in my body very directly and immediately when there's a frequency in this group where I'm like, ooh, it's like, I'll tell you a story. One time, okay, this is like a tiny little sidebar. So I love going to all these hot springs and I have a top secret vice of loving the occasional Mexi Coke, which are in the, it's Coca-Cola, but it's in the glass bottle. And it's like, it's made in Mexico with pure cane sugar rather than high fructose corn syrup. And so this is totally going to relate in just a second. And so, and I drink one of those, sometimes I get a headache and it really helps, but let's say I have like 10 of those a year, something like that. And so I was walking into a hot springs like area resort in Oregon called Brighton Bush. And I was carrying, I'll never forget this moment, my delicious, you know, top secret vice of the Mexico. And as soon as I walked onto like the sacred lands of Brighton Bush, I was like, oh God, I have to put this down. Like the Mexico, the codes of the Mexico were so like matrix infiltrated. And it just, it like felt so wrong and bad to my system that I was like, oh, code red. I have to get rid of this. Like, I can't even bring the empty bottle. I cannot pour this on the land. Like I have to back out of the magical Brighton Bush sacred hot springs land and like get rid of this Mexico because it was just like holding something that like it didn't hurt, but like it almost, it was like sharp where I was like, oh, I cannot take one step further. This has to be handled immediately. And it's a teeny bit like that in this group. When someone shows up, and this is said with so much love because this whole deal of graciousness and feminine consciousness, it's so like not supported and taught and reflected in the larger collective very frequently. So women come here to my group and they like crash into something that on a certain level feels amazing and that we have this deep heartache for and remembrance of. And there's going to be some like ego ride that's going to be kind of confronting, because if you show up in a non-gracious frequency, it's, I'm going to feel it. And I'm going to lovingly offer you adjustment without your like individual permission. I'm not going to, I used to be like, I have some thoughts on this, or I have a reflection. Would you like to receive that? I cannot do that, particularly because I have laid it out at a very overt level. This group is encoded in graciousness. Player's choice for every one of you. Like, if that doesn't feel good to you, or if you're like, I want my Phonic Wild Woman, please go to the Phonic Wild Woman group. And she will be deeply celebrated there, that aspect and dimension of you. This is no shaming of that, like, primordial, wild feminine. I have lots of that in my being. And this field is not the right place for that. Okay. And I will make that more overt, like, by consenting, this is the language that you really need to hear, ladies, by consenting to participate in this field, you are co-signing the codes that are architected into this field, which may not feel good to you or your ego, and you are yoked energetically and vibrationally to a value and a code of feminine quintessence of graciousness. So that is a little bit of, like, there's some compression around that. At first. So the thing that I want to say that I don't want to say, and once again, is very ironic in the context of graciousness, is if you are new to this group, I extend to you, and we all do, such a warm welcome. There's lots of you that just float in for this live stream, so you haven't yet received our welcome. You will be properly welcomed on Friday. We create a little welcome post for all the ladies, the new ladies in this group. I extend to you a very warm welcome, and it is my request that you don't post anything for 30-ish days, player's choice around that too, because if you haven't given your psyche and your system time to attune to the resonance of this group, it's likely that you, or there's a possibility more frequently than not, that you will show up in a way that I'm going to kind of feel at the level of the Mexico, where I'm like, ooh, that does not feel good to me. And I will offer an adjustment that, even though it's encoded in love and encoded to my devotion to brilliant feminine consciousness, it might not feel good. And so I don't want that to be, I mean, it's not that I don't want that to be, I wanted your experience here to be exactly right for you, but it can be a little bit of, like, bitter medicine just as you're tiptoeing into a field. So I want this field to feel very welcoming to you. And so for that reason, my request is, like, splunk around a little, like, explore the vibe. And let the vibe, and here's another, like, secret thing, not secret, but, like, not always lifted up into consciousness about the feminine. The feminine learns through resonance. I will even say that one step more confrontingly. We entrain to resonance. Through resonance, we entrain to fields. I'm going to go back to the beginning, which is why it is so important that you bring massive discernment to the fields you choose to participate in, including this one. So, okay, so I just want to kind of say hi, welcome. Please enjoy this field silently for a few weeks, 2 weeks even, so that you have the opportunity to behold the mastery and the magnificence of the women who have been a little bit through the eye of the graciousness needle, which we're going to weave this all through, because that will gift you something very sacred and very rare, which is an entrainment to a frequency that is like lost in so many ways or misunderstood. I'm not sure that it's lost, but I feel like it's deeply misunderstood, and it's certainly not being transmitted into feminine consciousness very frequently. Okay, so those are those pieces. I have a few notes that I just want to go through so that, okay. Okay, so we're going to talk a little bit about what we're talking about in a greater refinement. Graciousness. Graciousness. Graciousness, my goodness. Even the word, like I really just felt that. What is sourced and what graciousness and rooted it is rooted in, and this is very beautiful, is grace. Graciousness has two meanings. One is like to be courteous and kind and pleasant. And the second one is, and this one opens my heart very deeply, to be filled with the grace of God. To be filled with the grace of God. So if we look at these two elements, to be kind and pleasant, and then to be filled with the grace of God, what gets tricky in this listening is that there is no shadow of graciousness. Graciousness has no shadow, but there is a counterfeit expression of graciousness. And that counterfeit expression of graciousness is contortion, is manipulation, is transaction, is trying to get. And I would say that one of the deepest shadows, so this is where there is shadow in the feminine psyche, in the feminine system, is we can take frequencies that are very pure and we can stain them with our ego and our arrogance and our entitlement, and we can use them to get, to try to get. I'm gonna say, I feel like that is, like I know that place in me, where I can take something that's very exalted and very pure, and I can run that through the Jillian entitlement and ego Willy Wonka machine. And it can come out with all kinds of distortion inside of it because I've smeared it and stained it with ego and arrogance and entitlement, three big shadows of the collective feminine and within my own being, my own self. So, graciousness has no shadow. Grace has no shadow. It is a pure quintessence that contains within it immediately beauty. That's how we feel the human heart, the human spirit. Feels and recognizes graciousness because it is an internal, spiritual, pure, like sip of beauty that is incredibly life-affirming, incredibly nourishing, incredibly generative spiritually. And so I'm going to climb in back to our group, all the way up from the spiritual quintessence of graciousness as beauty, and say that something that happens, and I say this with so much compassion, is that I may offer a reflection like, this is a reminder, this group is encoded in graciousness. Your supreme graciousness is required. And like what you just shared was not it. And then sometimes we go back and we add some words, lovelies, or other words that decorate our post or our request for support or reflection. Ooh, I'm having a little wardrobe malfunction. That actually phones in and amplifies the counterfeit nature. It is the opposite, not the shadow, but it is the counterfeit, or what I've seen called the toxic mimic of grace and of graciousness. That is not what we're doing here. That is not true feminine graciousness. That is like sticking on some word stickers to try to sound gracious. That's a Mexico moment for me. That's like a where I'm like, oh gosh, we have like artifice instead of graciousness. And I say this lovingly and with compassion, and all of you, I'm going to say it again, we are practitioners together. I have places where my graciousness lapses that are startling to me to this day, where I'm like, ooh, I teach this. I hold very high values around this. And yet, significant lapses. So I want to include myself in this journey of being practitioners together, of cultivating this value of graciousness together. So the reason why graciousness matters, and I touched on this before, is because, and I used this word, and I want to talk about it for a minute, is because, and I'll repeat something I said earlier, although we're going a layer in more deeply. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? Just please stand by. I want to look at comments. Like, how is this going? I'm just going to take one peek. Please let me just, I want to, before I keep going. But wait, where's the comment? Oh, okay. Here's a few. Hi, ladies. Oh, it makes me so happy to see all these names. Oh, this is beautiful. Okay, so I think we're going, okay, perfect. I just wanted to check in. Okay, so, and I just saw someone quote this, and I'm gonna say it again. Graciousness cannot occupy the same energetic space as pain body. So as a teacher of the feminine, we don't get around this thing called the pain body. So I'm gonna talk about it just for a quick second. Minute. Pain body is a term from Eckhart Tolle. He talks about it very multidimensionally as almost having a, like, it's almost like a consumptive entity that feeds on itself and misery and more of itself. So it's consumptive, as I said, like it feeds on itself. There's a lot of like bigness in the multidimensional aspects or features of pain body that I'm going to kind of set aside and just name. You can Google Eckhart Tolle and you can read more about pain body, but I'm going to bring it down to like the woman, like who we are as women and our relationship to pain body. So pain body, it's a state of being that it's almost like an etheric layer of our woman, that where it's like our ancestral and our personal and the collective or transpersonal narratives of trauma and pain and actual imprints of trauma and pain live inside of us. So pain body, it's like there's a way that at a certain point of consciousness in our journey of awakening as women, as feminine women, that we encounter this part of ourselves or this aspect, psychic aspect of self called the pain body. And we have to choose. We have to choose every day, pain body or God, to quote the very brilliant and beloved Erica Jade. I teach from that a lot. Pain body or God. That fulcrum vibrationally, when a woman makes that choice, is what determines her capacity for graciousness. Because if she chooses unconsciously, this is not conscious, if she goes on the ride of pain body, either her own, or if she's colluding with the feminine layers of pain body, which are prevalent, there's no capacity for her to emanate graciousness. Remember, graciousness, to be filled with the grace of God. A profound point in feminine awakening and feminine consciousness is the choice that we make every day between pain body and God. Graciousness. To be filled with the grace of God. It's pain body or God. It's pain body or the state of being filled with the grace of God, which is graciousness. It is binary. You're not, well, let me say, it's binary and it may, like there may be evolution over a few moments. Like I know for myself very many times, I'm like, whoa, I am on a really big pain body ride. Woo! And I bring into consciousness the awareness, ooh, I am drunk on pain body right now. And then once I bring it into consciousness, because that's the only place where true sovereign choice can dwell in consciousness, and I make a choice. I either have to interrupt the pain body ride, which, not so easy, pain body loves the drunkenness of pain body inflammation. I either interrupt that or not, because, and this is the next piece of this that I love, because that I value, it's not even I value, like what I am here to, one of the primary frequencies that I'm here to serve in this incarnation is graciousness. So I am, as I said, that's highly encoded at the level of like my soul essenced gold print. So, and where this is how this serves feminine awakening. brilliantly and beautifully and potently, I choose graciousness imperfectly. I yoke to that value. And by doing so, because that's my highest or higher requirement at the level of my own Dharma, because I choose to yoke, be yoked to that frequency, I have to do my best to interrupt and disrupt and detonate the inflammation of pain body. And that is a golden key of feminine creational mastery. Right there. What are you choosing to be yoked to? And so there's radical misunderstanding of graciousness. Like, this is not your grandmother's graciousness. Just like how I said that art evolves in its technology and in its capacity to be expressed, as does consciousness, so does graciousness. This is not the like mores of yore, which is like, great, children must be seen and not heard. And that was a demonstration of etiquette that was linked to graciousness. This energetic signature and essence, quintessence of feminine awakening called graciousness is in service to your creational mastery. It's in service to your most refined, rarefied, sovereign expression as woman. This does not mean, here comes the counterfeit, another version of counterfeit. This does not mean that we behave nicely. This does not mean that we show up in artifice. This does not mean that we are meek in, oh my God, like feeling and expressing our desire. It means none of those things, but those are the low-hanging fruit of the counterfeit expression. So one of my co-teachers and dear friends, Agnes Mihalik, she has this beautiful smoking hot quote. She says, and I quote this all the time too, because I'm like, oh my God, it's so good. She says, My graciousness is matched only by my ruthlessness. Every time I hear that, I feel stuff all the way down to my pussy, because I'm like, oh, fuck yeah. My graciousness is matched only by my ruthlessness. Coming back to the group. And I see this frequently. And this is a very tender place of feminine awakening. A woman said she's like starting, she's tiptoeing back out into the dating field. And she's been noticing that some men like touch her on a date, like early when she's just getting to know them. And it doesn't feel good to her. And she was asking, like, how do I say that? What do I do? And I noticed that many women were like, oh, that's a signal from your body that, like, his touch is like kind of a visceral or unconscious way of your body letting you know that there's, like, not the right chemistry. And I'm like, this is true. This is true. And my heart fluttered a little bit. Because the next step down version of the counterfeit or toxic mimic of graciousness, if it's looked at behaviorally, is actually a trauma response. A trauma response called fawning. And fawning, this is tricky, because fawning contains great paradox within it too. Oh no. Okay, I'm going to speak to this single dimensionally about fawning. Fawning is a trauma response in which we unconsciously and reflexively default to people pleasing. We default to being nice. We default at its most severe and dangerous. We default to being nice or pleasing men or women who are harming us or who have intention to harm us or have caused injury to us. This is the place in me that like feels trepidation around teaching the highly coded mystical technology of graciousness to a nearly public field of all different levels of feminine consciousness, because there is no shadow of graciousness. There is misunderstanding and there is distortion. So if a woman does not have her no anchored very deeply in her body and has easeful access to no. And that level of sovereignty, she can pretend to make something be okay with her and internally name that as, I'm being gracious. That is not graciousness. That is not being filled with the grace of God. That is a reflex that is encoded in trauma and is encoded in something that lives inside of your system that you learned in order to keep yourself safe. So my graciousness is matched only by my ruthlessness. If we are experiencing something that does not feel good to us, we need to be able to say, thank you for your desire to touch me. It doesn't feel good to me to receive your touch. Or very many other versions of that. I'm just giving something that I would say. Thank you for your desire to touch me. It does not feel good for me to receive your touch, period. And I can say that, here's the paradox, graciously. It is more gracious to deliver truth than it is to unconsciously, and I say this so tenderly and compassionately, contort inside of an expression that isn't our truth and name that graciousness. We can feel the way that this is like layered and there's some complexity in this, but graciousness is not about behaving nicely. Graciousness is about having the cultivation and the consciousness to be able to speak what is true with us, for us, moment by moment, in a way, oh God, this is the whole next piece. Okay. In a way that reflexively causes or invites, let me say that, reflexively invites us to be more deeply protected, more deeply cherished, more deeply seen as the truth of our precious nature. And there's artistry in this. This is why we all are practitioners of graciousness. I will tell you very clearly, graciousness is a forging. Graciousness is a profound initiation for the feminine, for modern women. Graciousness is like at its exalted expression, which I would say is in many ways the only true energetic signature of grace and of graciousness, is a certain exaltation, a sacred exaltation. That this is a mystical, emergent, evolutionary, divine opportunity to allow ourselves to be forged, to be cultivated in our highest expression. Because we will learn as we deepen into this practice, it feels amazing. I am, and the women who journey like more deeply inside of my teaching spaces, we are, and I include myself, the women who are in my like more in my more intimate teaching spaces, these are like at the level, like these are like my fellow travelers in journeys of this journey of feminine awakening. Like we are, all of us, and I would say for the most, the large part, all of the women in the group, like we share a soul essence that my sense is like the world is ready for to have a sovereign, potentiated expression of feminine consciousness and feminine nature that is masterful. And graciousness is a skeleton key inside that unlocking. And what we will discover, and this is what I was just saying, is that it feels amazing. Someone just wrote on my Facebook post about this graciousness live stream. She said, I'm so like paraphrasing, graciousness has let me love myself more because I didn't realize how actually bad it felt when I was being unconsciously non-gracious. And I was like, oh my gosh, exactly. We don't know how bad it feels vibrationally and physiologically to our beingness when we are showing up non-graciously, because that means we are unconscious about the truth of our creational mastery. We haven't unlocked the full expression of that radiance and of that beauty and of that cultivation, of that artistry. So graciousness feels amazing. It feels like it's a little wobbly along the way. Like sometimes I'm like, oh, like I said, I will totally lift the veils. Like I have many lapses, many pockets in my world space and in my own consciousness where I'm like, oh, wow. Like there is, graciousness does not dwell there. And where graciousness does not dwell, unconsciousness, pain body, immaturity, less sophistication, non-elegance, dwells. I'm going to look at my notes just to see. I think also, I wasn't sure how long this was. Oh gosh, there's a whole other thing doing. Oh goodness. All right. I got two other. So this, I didn't know how long this was going to be, but we're going to go over a little while longer. Okay. So back to my group. Wait, I'm going to check comments and then we're going to have two big pieces here. Okay. Hang on. Let's look. Okay, so far, I think everything is going, okay, I think it's all going swimmingly out there. if you're just watching, like, please say hello, ahem, greet the field, cough, cough, oh, the irony. You have an opportunity to practice, my dears. Okay, back to the group. So this group, point number two, when you ask to be a participant in this group, is I say something like, this group stands in devotion to the masculine. It's actually like I'm amazed at the brilliance retroactively, because I'm like, okay, here's the deal. This group is not safe. Your supreme graciousness is required. And this group stands in devotion to the masculine, which is probably the primordial source of feminine pain body, which is what will be most chargy and confronting to our capacity to emanate graciousness. So there is a lot of energetic tension and compression around. I did not intend to do this, but looking back, I'm like, wow, like this is advanced. You ladies are like advanced players here. So I really just want to honor, like now that I'm like looking at the energetics of this, I was like, ooh, this is a highly activating like trifecta of energetics that you need to meet inside yourself in a highly purified way. Like truly. Okay. So I said it a little bit before. Graciousness is recognized by the human spirit in a heartbeat. Literally, in a heartbeat, we recognize graciousness by its energetic signature, which is beauty, which is beauty. There's other qualities or dimensions of graciousness, but I would say it's like foundational essence is beauty. Beauty is in such exquisite service to life. To life. Graciousness and beauty are in profound service to women. Like our graciousness is in profound, life-affirming, generative service to one another. And so when we are in a field together that we co-create, that requires and celebrates graciousness, it's like, oh my God, that is exponential beauty and radiance. And it doesn't mean we have to get flowery. It doesn't mean that we have to say hello, lovely. Somebody. It doesn't have to look a certain way, but our graciousness and allowing the purification and the initiation and the forging of graciousness and then sharing that imperfectly with one another is like a gestalt of incredible beauty and incredible radiance. So I love that we get to share this together, truly. Like that fills my heart with so much joy. Secondly, graciousness and the masculine. feminine graciousness is a profound and exquisite source of fuel for men in the masculine. Again, tricky, because this is not about behaving a certain way, behaving nicely. This is about having a relationship to our truth and elegance at the same time. This is about having a relationship to our truth and a choice point that isn't pain body that we source in. And so I find, like, so for example, I had a client and she's a fiery firecracker of a woman. Love her. Spicy. And she, in her relationship with her man, but Jillian, I have a right to tell him exactly how I feel and what I think and what I want and other things. And I'm like, oh, you have that right. Oh my gosh. I so support you having that right to, like, hot tamale your feelings and your thoughts and your desires all over him. I support your right in that 100%. And my secret suspicion is that if we continue to journey in this container together, that you might find that there is a choice that you get to make and that you choose to make in your sovereign feminine consciousness that feels better. That once you start touching it and sipping it, you're like, oh my God, I am so potent in my expression. And what I receive back from him is beyond my wildest dreams. Maybe a little bit of hyperbolic, like, not exaggeration, because that does happen, but, like, I don't want to just, like, that's not a promise. It's just, like, something that I absolutely see occur over and over again. So not for a second am I trying to like diminish your fire, your spicy, your wildness. All of those things are sacred and rightful dimensions of the spectrum of feminine expression. I just think that once you allow the deeper initiation, you can choose. Like, I have a very intimate relationship with my carnality and my wildness and my sex and my blood that I would not necessarily like identify as being recognized externally as gracious, but it is no less. I am no less filled with the grace of God in those moments than I am when I am practicing cultivating my feminine mastery. So women, particularly the women who find, and we're all going to know this part of ourselves potentially, and certainly we hear this trope and this narrative, I'm too much for him. He can't handle a woman like me. I feel some type of way about those statements, I will tell you. Because that is not the whole story. She is playing inside of a very certain broadband of consciousness and has not yet discovered or chosen to experience the full range of feminine consciousness, which includes the quintessence of graciousness. Okay, the last thing, and this is gonna be a little bit abrupt and then we're gonna wrap, is this. If you are in my field and you are a wife, I'm going to hold you responsible to a whole other level of graciousness. Because when you are a wife, you have a spiritual responsibility to the sacred vows of your marriage, to the sacred union that you have templatized and codified through marriage. This is a tricky one for me to say, because there are women who are married and they come into my space and they spill intimate details, sometimes of the erotic, intimate nature of their relationship with their husband. And I have very strong feelings about that, because I want women to use this group and to participate in this group by sharing our wisdom and our lived experience and our gnosis. The feminine learns kaleidoscopically. We learn through resonance and reflection. This is a highly coded, rarefied frequency that I want us all to participate in and benefit from. And this is a free group on Facebook. And it is not the right place for a gracious wife to seek reflection about the inner sanctum of her marriage. We have lost, and I'm going to say it, the 50 or 60% divorce rate situation is reflective of this. We have lost the beauty of the graciousness that is encoded and activated inside the mantle of wife. I am not, here's the paradox, I am not legally married right now in this lifetime. And I will still hold your feet, if you are married, to a higher caliber and a higher standard of graciousness than if you were not. So you need to hear that. You need to hear that and make the choices that are right for you about choosing to be in this field, with all of its layers of paradox and complexity and requirements and that compression, the trifecta of the compression. This is not a safe space. Your supreme graciousness is required. And I stand in unequivocal devotion to the masculine in this field. That does not mean that I will not hold, that I do not recognize the very real harmful footprint and sometimes handprint onto our bodies of distorted men in the masculine. That is not what I'm saying. This is not about bypassing that truth. It is about you having to find your energetic rightness with that trifecta in order to be here. And if you are a wife, little extra heat. Eye of the needle. This doesn't mean that you cannot share about your husband. I want wives sharing about their husbands and about their relationships, but you need to choose how and what you share inside of a group of 1,500 women that is free on Facebook, and truly question if that is the most gracious field for you to receive rightful counsel. I will say, when you are dealing with a group of this size, and I know we're not that big, but it's large enough that we are dealing with various levels of consciousness, and you share something very tender and very intimate about your relationship, you are literally lifting the window to allowing poison arrows into your consciousness and into your marriage. It doesn't mean that these women weren't incredibly well-intended. If there's unconscious collusion between her pain body and your pain body, even as I said, if it's unconscious, you are not going to get clean reflection. And you need to be responsible for that, for allowing yourself to receive that. So, wife codes have a very different, not very different, but different enough that I hold a different standard of purification and excellence in your feminine consciousness and mastery. And if you share something here that doesn't feel good to me, because my commitment is to creating a field where we are individually and collectively filled with the grace of God, graciousness, and that that field stands in devotion to the masculine, in service of feminine awakening. It's not just like I'm in devotion to the masculine. I'm in devotion to the masculine because of how it initiates and because of the way it is in sacred service, like nothing else, in this embedded context between masculine and feminine, man and woman on this planet that will serve your awakening at that level of potency. So graciousness requires you to bring consciousness to your choices, pain body or God, at its most elemental. And then to make choices that reflect your or the value of graciousness more so than spilling your pain body. It does not mean that you cannot share what hurts you or where you would like reflection or where you would like to better understand a blind spot or a trauma. That is all welcome here. Inside of the cultivation, the initiatory practice of graciousness. Okay, I'm feeling complete-ish. There's so much more I could say and do say about graciousness and its relationship to feminine creational mastery. I am in such service to women experiencing the sweetest fruits of ecstasy and devotion and love and play and sweetness and mastery in their lived experience in this incarnation as of being a woman. We are so blessed. Okay, I think I'm gonna feel into anything else. This always, you know, I take the notes. I kind of bring it all through for days and days before the thing, and then it has its own journey once I really open to like receive what it is that wants to come through. So thank you, ladies, for being with me today. I appreciate you profoundly. I know that these can sting a little bit, that these codes or these remembrances can sting a little bit. So I truly honor, and I understand now even more so, like the trifecta of compression and energetics that you're inside of. And I'm like, whoo, that is quite a like sacred geometric. There's like a word that I want to use, like titration. So I appreciate all of you so much. I love being in this group with you. I love learning from you, and I love co-creating with all of you. And I appreciate practicing together. We learn together. Okay, if you're interested in deepening in, All for Love, right around the corner. I'll share more either later today or tomorrow, but we are like, the ladies are kind of flocking in, and it is such a magical, exquisite, elite frequency of feminine consciousness, and I love that. So I feel so excited. Okay, have a beautiful, today's Tuesday, Ruby Tuesday. See you in the group. Thank you so much, ladies. Love you and appreciate you.